Hello everyone, welcome to our Practical Hub channel. In third year first semester, we have three labs. Those are Unix lab, microprocess and microcontrollers lab, and also the web technologies lab. In Unix lab, the main objectives of this lab are to familiarize the students with the Unix environment, to learn a variety of common Unix utilities, to learn the fundamentals of shell scripting, to write C programs that use Unix system call interface. And the main outcomes of this lab are the students will be able to implement the basic commands and file system utilities in Unix environment, develop programs using shell scripting, implement various commands using system calls, develop programs using inter-process communication mechanisms. And the next lab is microprocess and microcontrollers lab. The main objectives of this lab are to familiarize the architecture of 8086 processor, assembly language programming, and interfacing with various modules. The student can also understand 8051 microcontroller concepts, architecture, programming, and application of microcontrollers. The main outcomes of this lab are the students will be able to apply knowledge of the microprocessor's internal registers and operations by use of a PC-based microprocessor simulator. Design electrical circuitry to the microprocessor I/O ports in order to interface the processor to external devices. Develop assembly language programs and download the machine code that will provide solutions such as fluid level control, temperature control, and batch processes. And the next lab is Web Technologies lab. The main objectives of this lab are to create static and dynamic web pages, to create DTD and XML schema for defining XML documents, to develop pure dynamic web application using JDBC, to develop server programming dynamically using servlets and Java server pages. The main outcomes of this lab are the students will be able to develop static and dynamic web pages using HTML, CSS and JavaScript, populate XML data using XML schema, perform SQL operations on data using JDBC and servlets, and generate the dynamic content using JSP. In third year second semester, we have three labs. Those are OOAD lab, DM lab, and computer graphics and algorithms lab. In OOAD lab, the main objectives of this lab are to provide knowledge on designing software application using object-oriented paradigm, to discuss various UML diagrams for a given application, to design a system using UML diagrams with respect to various architectural views. The main outcomes of this lab are the students will be able to analyze and design structural diagrams, construct UML diagrams to model the behavioral aspects of for a given problem, construct UML diagrams to model the dynamic behavior of a system, design the architectural aspects of a system. And the next lab in this semester is DM lab. The main objectives of this lab are to perform data pre-processing operations, to implement various data mining techniques to understand data mining processes, to gain familiarity with various stages of KDD for an application, to provide hands-on experience on data mining tools. The main outcomes of this lab are the students will be able to perform various operations on data pre-processing, implement association rule mining algorithms, apply different classification techniques, analyze data using clustering techniques. And the next lab is computer graphics and algorithms lab. The main objectives of this lab are to introduce the basics of output primitives through OpenGL, to design different types of transformations in graphics, to gain familiarity with different types of clipping and polygon algorithms. And the main outcomes of this lab are the students will be able to implement different types of interactive graphics programs using OpenGL, develop various transformations in graphics, build an interactive graphics program to perform various clipping algorithms, and also to implement an interactive graphics program to perform polygon filling. Thank you.